Bizzibox's expert information on buying cheese. How do I tell the quality of cheese?
The short answer is eat it. I mean, if something's good to eat, we pretty much all know that. I think some people can be intimidated when they go into, say, a big cheese shop like ours. There's a lot of things to choose from. But at the end of the day, if you know what you like, then you should buy what you like. And people tend to know when something's good quality. But to be honest, if you're buying something which is unpasteurised, it's probably going to be better quality. If it's smaller production, if it's handmade, these things aren't gimmicks. They actually do make a better end product. Ultimately, the more somebody puts into a product, the more you're going to get out of it. So really, I'd go to a good trusted retailer and make sure you taste the cheese before you get it. That's the best way to decide if a cheese is good or not. I wouldn't presume to tell people what they want to eat, but that's really what I suggest, you know.
Should I try cheese before I buy it?
I think you should always taste cheese before you buy it, if you're spending a lot of money on it anyway. I mean, small production cheese costs more than larger production cheese. It's just the nature of the beast. And if you're spending 20, 30, 40, 50 pounds a kilo on a cheese, you deserve to know what you're taking home before you take it home. The other thing is with unpasteurised cheeses, they change. I mean, not just with season to season, I think people kind of get that as an idea, but literally week to week and day to day, every different batch will be subtly different. So just because you've had a cheese 1 week and liked it, doesn't mean you're going to like the same cheese the next week. People think I'm exaggerating, but in fact, that's a fact of the matter. So we make sure that everybody tastes everything before they take it home in our shop. That way, everybody goes home happy and they don't feel like we've ripped them off. And we don't want to rip people off either. So I'd say definitely always try before you buy. And if they won't let you, shop somewhere else.
How should cheese be packaged?
To be honest, when you buy it, when it's in the shop, it shouldn't really be packaged, for the most part. If it's a big cheese, really you should be having it cut fresh from the block and then wrapped up and given to you. The longer a piece of cheese stays in its in the big form, the happier and healthier and moister and tastier that it's going to be. As soon as you chop it off a bit of cheese, it's going to dry out and start deteriorating. So if you're getting top-end cheese, I'd say it should actually be cut to order for you. Some of the smaller individual cheeses, like goat's cheeses, they're going to be wrapped up. But if they are wrapped up, cling film, avoid. Wax paper, things like that, that's the best thing for wrapping cheese in. Once you get into sort of block cheddars and so forth, it's less of an issue because they're less inert and there's less flavours in there in the first place, so it's going to affect them less. But if you're buying good cheese, like expensive cheese, it should be cut for you there and then and should be wrapped in a good quality paper.
What tips can you give me on buying cheese?
If you want to buy good cheese, you need to go to a good cheese shop or somebody who sells, you know, who looks after the cheese and allows you to taste it before you buy it. I can't iterate that enough, I don't think. You know, often what we're used to when we're buying cheese is rows of cheese in a cold counter, and all we've got to go on is the price and the packaging. If you're paying more for your cheese, you should really be getting it off somebody who's looking after it properly. Plastic is terrible for cheese. It's really bad for it. Mummifying it in cling film is one of the worst things you can do to good cheese. So really, you want to go to a place where it's not wrapped up in plastic, where you can try it before you buy it. And also, you can get information from the person who's selling it to you. You can ask them about it, learn about it, or maybe they can guide you to something that they think you might like. So I'd say go to a good shop, try it. That's the best way to get the best cheese, I'd say.
What can I expect to pay for a wedge of cheese?
It's obvious to say it, but it depends very much on the piece of cheese that you're getting. For example, something like a cow's milk cheese is always going to be cheaper than a goat's or a sheep's milk cheese, for the simple reason that goats and sheep's are just as much work, really, as a cow, but you get a lot less milk out of them, so there's a lot less to sell at the end of the day. So you're going to pay more for sheep, more for goat. So cow's cheese is going to be cheaper. Often the bigger blocks of cheese are going to be cheaper as well, because it's less work for a farmer or a cheesemaker to make one big cheese than lots of little individual cheeses. So things like that can add to the costs. A good example of that are things like baby Stiltons. We only sell the big Stiltons, A, because the baby Stiltons don't mature as well, but B, because they cost more, because it's more work to make lots of little cheeses than one big cheese. You're going to pay more for something which isn't as good. So what you're going to pay will depend on things like size of production, milk type. That's the kind of thing. But at the end of the day, you know, if you taste something and you think it's great and you want to buy it, what you're willing to spend on something is kind of what the value of it is, I suppose, at the end of the day. but you're always going to pay more for goats and sheep and small production.
What is the most expensive cheese you have eaten?
The most expensive cheese I've ever seen was actually given to me by a Swedish guy, and it was in a jar, and it was made from moose or elk milk, and it was about £80 a kilo, because elk and moose don't give much milk, and they're pretty hard to milk, I suspect, and looking after a herd of moose must be pretty hard work. I asked the guy who gave me it, is the guy who makes this insane? And he said, yeah, he pretty much is insane. So that's the most expensive cheese I've ever seen. It was quite nice. I'm not sure if it was worth £80 a kilo, though.
www.bizzybox.com